Sjogren syndrome is an autoimmune disease that targets the lacrimal or crying glands and salivary ducts in our mouth. This causes a constellation of symptoms that I remember with the GEM acronym. This includes glandular enlargement, dry eyes, and dry mouth. However, it can also cause some dangerous extraglandular issues like lymphoma. To classify the disease, think of it as either primary, where it occurs alone, or secondary if it overlaps with rheumatoid arthritis or other autoimmune diseases. To make its pathophysiology really clear, just remember that it causes two things. Firstly, B-cell hyperactivity, which produces a variety of immunoglobulins like anti-Rho and anti-La. Secondly, it induces lymphocytic infiltration of the exocrine glands, causing dysfunction, particularly in the salivary and lacrimal ones. Let's now expand on its clinical features by breaking down the GEM issues. Don't forget to subscribe if you're loving my channel's mnemonics, by the way. G stands for enlarged glands due to chronic inflammation. These are usually firm and non-tender with either unilateral or bilateral enlargement, and it's most obvious in the parotid glands. E stands for eyes that are dry and irritated due to a reduction in the aqueous component of tears. This is medically termed keratoconjunctivitis sicca and gives patients an unpleasant, gritty or sandy feeling in their eyes. M stands for dry mouth caused by chronic salivary hypofunction. This is medically described as xerostomia. Decreased saliva production increases the risk of dental caries and oral candidiasis. Now, if you have GEMS, you might also have a MAP, which is my acronym for the extraglandular features of SS. M stands for malignancy, specifically lymphoma. This is by far the most serious complication of SS and confers up to a 9-fold increase in risk. The tumors are usually extranodal, meaning that they arise within exocrine glands. A stands for antibody deposition. Now, immune complex mediated disease often causes a strange vasculitis or dermatological stigmata like a rash. Finally, P stands for periepithelialitis. This describes the immune response in ductal epithelial structures within a variety of organs like the kidney, causing things like interstitial nephritis. Now, don't forget that other non-specific symptoms like Raynaud phenomenon and fatigue are also really common too. Now, further investigation for Sjogren syndrome is required if a patient has significant sicca symptoms. A diagnosis requires both evidence of an underlying autoimmunity and objective glandular changes. Autoimmunity can be shown in three ways. Firstly, a positive serology for anti-Rho or anti-La. Secondly, a biopsy of the minor salivary glands which show lymphocytic infiltrates. Finally, if a patient has a well-established systemic rheumatic disease. Evidence of glandular damage can be shown in four ways. Firstly, a Schmirmer test, which measures tear production by placing a strip of paper over the lower eyelid and quantifying how wet it becomes. Ocular surface staining can be done to empirically measure eye damage caused by dryness. Whole salometry, which is a method to quantify salivary hypofunction. And finally, imaging like an MRI or an ultrasound can show evidence of parenchymal abnormalities. Moving on, the actual management of Sjogren syndrome is very basic and largely symptomatic. Sicca symptoms can be managed with artificial tear supplements, cyclosporine eye drops, or cholinergic drugs. Complication screening and treatment is also important to consider, especially for lymphoma and rheumatoid arthritis. Let's recap all of this with my mnemonic to summarize its diagnostic criteria. SS requires proof of autoimmunity, like a positive anti-Rho or anti-La, and evidence of glandular dysfunction, which you can quantify with dye, cry, MRI, or saliva. The dye is a reminder that you can do ocular surface staining. Reduced crying can be measured with a Schmirmer test. Tissue damage can sometimes be seen on imaging. And saliva hypofunction can be measured with xylometry. Make sure you check out my playlist if you love easy ways to remember medicine. Thanks for watching Townsend Teachings.